In previous lecture, we were discussing about Precambrian life. That was the life that is actually related to the kind of events that were serving as the baseline of geological time scale. And at the end of Precambrian life, the most of the organisms that were represented were kind of mineralized phyla. They began to appear at the end of Precambrian life. Now, today we will discuss about post-Cambrian life, or what kind of life was actually present in post-Cambrian time period. So we can simply say that Cambrian period or post-Cambrian period is actually the earliest time division of Paleozoic era. It extends from 541 million years ago to 485.4 million years ago. In previous lecture, I was discussing about when we have discussed about Precambrian life that was started that was related to the Earth formational process, in which oxygen began to accumulate and some prokaryotes and eukaryotes were originated, and that was almost starting from 4,600 billion years ago million years ago to it was actually ended at 541 or 542. So these values are actually a bit same. So it also extends from 541 million years ago to 485.4 million years ago. The Cambrian period is actually the time period that is divided into four stratigraphic series. The number one series is the Ternovian series. It starts from 541 million years ago to 521 million years ago. And then we will have series two that starts from 521 million years ago to million years ago to 509 million years ago. Then we will have the series number three that is having 509 million years ago to 497 million years ago. Then we will have a Ferengian series. This series actually extends from ranges from 497 million years ago to 485.4 million years ago. So we can simply say Cambrian period is actually the earliest division of Paleozoic era, and it extends from 541 million years ago to 485 million years ago. And we will discuss all the events, all the activities that are actually carried out within this short time period in earliest Earth history. So if we discuss about the characteristics of the post-Cambrian life or Cambrian period, we can simply say it is the first geological period of Paleozoic era, and it accounts from 541 0.5 to 488.3 million years ago. These values are actually a bit same, so we can have kind of different values. These values are actually bit related. We did not actually differentiate about all these values. If we discuss about the general characteristics of this post-Cambrian life, we can simply say that post-Cambrian was the time period that was very unique in origin. And why this was unique in its origin? It was unique because it has higher deposition of lagerstätten in sedimentary rock deposits. Lagerstättens are actually the type of organisms, the type of creatures that are a bit soft-bodied along with some mineralized shell organisms. So these kind of organisms were specifically associated with post-Cambrian rocks, post-Cambrian strata. So the post-Cambrian time period was very unique in erosion because of deposition of larger amount of lagerstätten bodies in rock strata. The Cambrian period is actually marked by very profound evolutionary change in terms of life form. So we can simply say this was actually time period that was specifically related to the kind of different types of evolutionary changes that were related to different types of life forms origination. And one of the major event that is actually specifically associated with this post-Cambrian event is this post-Cambrian time period is the Cambrian explosion. Cambrian explosion is important in terms of major life phyla origination. So we can call this, we can designate this Cambrian, post-Cambrian life as it, this is actually the time period where most of the major life phylums were originated. This Cambrian explosion can also be called as Cambrian radiations. In this diagram, if you in this diagram you can see this was the early pre-Cambrian, then late pre-Cambrian. These were actually the kind of rock strata that were having different types of prokaryotes and eukaryotic organisms. In early pre-Cambrian, we can simply say this was the time when the rocks that were associated with studied under that time period were having kind of prokaryotic and simple eukaryotic organisms that were not giving us any kind of idea, any kind of evidence about the type of organisms that were actually present. So this early pre-Cambrian and late pre-Cambrian was the time period, was that we enough time that was related to the earth formational processes in which oxygen began to accumulate, some prokaryotes and some bacteria actually began to appear in the this time period. If we move from this late pre-Cambrian to early Cambrian, we can have a kind of data in rocks data that is related to different types of organisms. This means we can simply say the Cambrian explosion is actually the evidence of fossil record is related to the evidence that are having different types of fossil remains. Fossils are actually the kind of organisms that were once living and they were died. They were lying beneath the different earth layers. So we can simply say at this pre-Cambrian, this post-Cambrian is actually the time that was showing evidence in terms of fossil record and major life phylums that were established in the transition from late pre-Cambrian to earlier Cambrian earlier Cambrian time. It is actually the kind of model that is representing descendants of original created kinds that become the extinct during the flood of Genesis. The post-Cambrian is actually the time period that was actually marked by different types of events. That when there were certain types of organisms, they were present in this diagram. You can say these are actually the types of organisms, different types of echinoderms, hemichordates, and crocodiles, mollusks, worms, different types of creatures were actually present in these rocks earlier. So we are designating this as a explosion of all life forms, and then gradual evolutionary processes actually accounts for the sudden appearance of so many types of lifetime. So we can simply say that some organisms were present in different types of rock layers in a consistency, in a quantity that was representing that the there was sudden events that were actually related to the formation of different origination of different types of organisms. Then they went extinct several times during these events. So in this diagram you can very clearly see there is actually the Cambrian explosion or Cambrian radiation, and at the base of all these organisms there was no such type of organisms that can we represent in this diagram. And in this is actually the time period that is actually starting from 541 to 542 million years ago, and it ranges from and we can categorize, we can actually calculate that data in various forms. In this diagram you can see different types of organisms. All these are the type of organisms that were actually present to up to date, and we are actually utilizing all these organisms to study the evolutionary processes or evolutionary changes that are related to Cambrian life forms. In this diagram, you can simply see that in previous lecture I was discussing about different divisions of pre-Cambrian life, and this is actually the Paleozoic time period we are actually discussing about. It is actually the major division of Paleozoic, and we can divide this into earlier, middle, and late further subdivisions. And these are actually the time divisions that were actually having small shelly fossils diversification. As we have discussed in previous lecture, there was the formation of Ediacaran or Menetian biota. These were the kind of organisms that were showing different types of small bony structure or some kind of skeletal structure began to appear in the fossil record. They were actually marked at the boundary. boundary of this Precambrian time period, then the Paleozoic was the kind of division that was having a marked that actually involved marked evolutionary processes, and these evolutionary processes facilitate the formation of different types of mineralized organisms. They were having kind of shells, kind of bony structure that they began to appear in fossil record. So we can simply say there was diversification in different types of life forms was observed during Cambrian time period. As we have discussed, that Cambrian explosion is actually the kind of major event that is that we have studied in this post-Cambrian life. Cambrian explosion actually shows the animal were actually evolving monophyletically. In this diagram, you can simply say all these organisms are actually having the kind of region they are related to same ancestor. It means all the major life phylums that are originated, that are present up to today, they have a kind of single monophyletic region. It means their ancestors were same and they descended from same organism. So we can simply say all these organisms were sharing common ancestors. So this Cambrian explosion actually show all these organisms that are actually present today, that is actually one school of thought, they are evolved monophyletically. So we can simply say that all the Cambrian organisms that we have studied in fossil record, they actually fall at the base of the modern animal phyla. That is actually the specific character which is related to different types of organisms that were present in the base of the Cambrian studies. So we can say mineralized phyla, they were actually the kind of organisms that were present in different types of fossil record. And as I have discussed earlier in a previous lecture, that Cambrian for preservation of any kind of organism, it becomes mandatory. It is actually the requirement of organism to become fossilized. It should have some type of bony material. The bony material might have chance to become preserved in fossil records as compared to soft-bodied organisms. Soft-bodied organisms are actually very rare in fossil records. They are actually very few that are actually studied in different types of fossilization processes. So it is actually the kind of character that is related to the preservation of organism, that the different types of bony structures or mineralization is actually the kind of event that is related to the preservation of organisms. So they contribute important role in fossil record. If we discuss about the if we are discussing about the different types of life forms that are related to this post-Cambrian life, during post-Cambrian or Cambrian period, the plant life first appeared on the land. This was actually time period when the different types of plants began to appear on different types of lands. These changes actually allowed the formerly aquatic animals species to invade the land and feeding directly on the plants or decaying vegetation. It means initially the life was originated in aquatic environment that were having different types of microbial mats or microbial scums, and these scums actually were inhibited by different types of organisms, and these organisms gradually start in invasion towards terrestrial environment. From aquatic environment, these animals actually start a kind of behavior that facilitate their terrestrial mode of life. So these changes allowed aquatic animals, different types of aquatic species, to invade on the land. And they were actually feeding on different types of plant vegetation, and the microbial mats were destroyed by different types of behavioral activities, like competition or different types of ecological relationships. So the Cambrian time period was marked by the origination of the formation of plant life. They began to appear on the land. Then these continual changes in the temperature and moisture throughout the remainder of the Paleozoic era, it means the Paleozoic era was the kind of era that was involving the kind of events that were significant in terms of temperature and moisture. It means humidity, rainfall or precipitation. These were the events. They were facilitating the formation of different types of processes, and all these processes facilitate the kind of changes which were suitable for different types of organisms. So they start building different types of habitat on land. Due to the continental plate movements that were encouraged due to the development of new adaptation to terrestrial existence in animals, such limbed appendages in the amphibians and epidermal scale in the reptile. It's mean due to the different types of events that were actually required for the for their existence on different types of habitats, the terrestrial existence that we are actually using as example is the development of different types of limbed appendages in amphibians and epidermal scales in Nepal. It means initially there were aquatic animals start moving towards land, and on land they adapted themselves according to the conditions that were present. They can have mode of life that can be aquatic and terrestrial as well. You might have an idea, amphibians and reptiles are actually the kind of organism that can live in water and terrestrial environment at the same time. So these are actually the type of changes in environment that often create actually the new niches or living species that contribute to the rapid speciation and increased diversity. It means these environmental changes were actually responsible for the rapid speciation of different types of species. So there was diversification in different types of life form. The different types of environmental events, environmental changes actually facilitate different types of habitats for different types of organisms, and the life was actually, we can say, the life was diversified during post-Cambrian time period. Plants began to appear, and then different types of aquatic animals, they start moving towards terrestrial environment, and they adapted themselves according to different types of environmental conditions, and this involved the rapid speciation and increased diversity. So life become diversified on land. See, this was actually the one phenomena that was related to the organisms diversification process. On the other hand, there were certain types of catastrophic events that are catacyclic events, such as volcanic eruptions and meteorite strikes, that obliterate life and can result in devastating losses of the diversity. Such periods of mass extinction. We are actually discussing about the post-Cambrian life that is related to the formation of or origination of different types of plants and animal species. On the other hand, different types of catastrophic events, they were also present, and these catastrophic events were the kind of volcanic eruption or different types of geomorphological events that were actually disturbing the different types of life that were present at that time. So we can say that there was different types of time period that were involving the kind of mass extinctions. It's mean the type of species, the type of organisms that were actually present at that time, they went extinct on certain places of the world. At the end of the Permian period and the Paleozoic era, they were actually marked by the largest max extinction events in the Earth history and the loss of roughly 95% of the extant species at that time. We can simply say that this Paleozoic era actually involved marked profound changes was observed in form of largest mass extinction. It's mean these were the kind of events that were involving the extinction or removal of almost 95% of the species that were actually present at the time. It's mean in terms of fossil record, in terms of stratification, there were the type of rock strata that were devoid of any kind of evidences about life forms. So these are marked by global mass extinction processes. Some of the dominant phyla in the world's oceans, such as trilobites, disappeared completely. I mean, we can say different types of organisms that were actually dominant in different in aquatic environment. Trilobite is actually the kind of example that is maximum that we are actually using maximum in paleontology. They went extinct completely. They become disappeared from the fossil record. Trilobites are actually the one organism. So we can have different types of organisms like ammonites, graptolites, and brachiopods as well. These organisms are actually the kind of representative organisms that were present at that time, and among them some went extinct. In this topic, we are actually discussing about different types of life forms that were related to post-Cambrian time period. Then there were different types of plants that radiated into new landscapes and empty niches, creating complex communities to produce communities of producers and consumers, some of which become very large on the abundant food available. It's mean on the one side, there was the process of diversification that was involving the diversification of different types of animal life phyla that were present at the base of present modern organisms phylum, and on the other side, the plants were undergoing different types of radiational processes. It means they were also undergoing different types of they were also the plants were also adopting different types of communities, different types of environment. It means there was different types of successional processes that were related to the formation of different types of plants communities. And definitely when there were plants were actually inhabiting different types of lands, they were disturbed by different types of animals. So we can say these two processes are actually working in harmony. On the one side, animal species and animal kingdom was diversified. On the other hand, there was a plant kingdom was also undergoing different types of diversification processes. Different types of successional processes were facilitating the formation of complex climatic communities of different types of plants. Then there was the different types of mass extinctional events were occurring at end of the Cretaceous period, beginning the Mesozoic era to the end. The skies darkened and the temperature fell to the large meteor impacts, and the ton of volcanic ashes blocked the incoming sunlight. It means the Earth history is actually involving the different types of events which were involving different types of mass extinctional processes that were occurring at different rates, that were involving the kind of events in which the sky becomes totally dark. This means the sunlight was blocked, and the catastrophic event that was related to that the life was the different types of volcanic eruptions were actually responsible for the formation of different types of fumes or fog-like condition. So the sunlight was totally blocked, and these also facilitated provoked towards the extinction processes. And when there was no sunlight, you can simply say plants were actually unable to do the process of photosynthesis. The plants died. Herbivores and carnivores starved, and the most cold-blooded dinosaurs ceded and dominance of the landscape to the more warm-blooded animals. It's mean the Earth evolutionary processes actually involve the kind of events that were facilitating one type of organism at one side, and they were actually the cause of inhibition of different types of organisms. In that cases, different types of plant species, they were died, and herbivores and carnivores becomes starving, and most of the cold-blooded organism, among them different types of dinosaurs, they died, and some warm-blooded animals, organisms, they began to well adapted to environment. In the following Cenozoic era, the mammals radiated into the terrestrial and aquatic niches once occupied by the dinosaurs, birds, and warm-blooded animals, offshoot of the one line of the ruling reptiles. And they become aerial specialists. It means there was the process of diversification that is involving the different types of events in which mammal radiated into the mammals they were radiated into the terrestrial and aquatic niches that were occupied by different types of dinosaurs and birds and different types of warm-blooded animals. They were actually serving as the offshoots of the different types of organisms that were initially the amphibians and reptiles. It's mean there was initially the kind of organisms that were actually the bottom. They were actually related to the sea bottom. They were bottom dwellers. From bottom dwellers, they adapted to different types of terrestrial environment. From terrestrial environment, different types of mammals were originated. Different types of tetrapodous organisms were originated. They become common in different types of fossilicarts, and then different types of organisms that were aerial specialists, mean different types of bird species were originated. The appearance and dominance of flowering plants in the Cenozoic era created new niches of the for the insects as well as for the birds and mammals, and changes in the animal species diversity during the late Cretaceous and early Cenozoic were also prominent during dramatic shifts. There was actually the time period that was involving the dominance of flowering plants in the Cenozoic era that created a new habitat for different types of insects as well as birds and mammals, and changes in the animal species diversity during the late Cretaceous and early Cenozoic was the time period that promoted the dramatic shift. It's mean all these events were facilitating different types of organisms, and these events involve the development of different types of habitats that were suitable for different types of organisms. We have an idea that this post-Cambrian or Cambrian life was the kind of Devian, that is actually the Devian of Paleozoic era. And in this era, there was at the start of this Paleozoic era, or at the start of this post-Cambrian, hard bony-shell creature began to appear, and gradually there was different types of evolutionary processes, different types of successional processes that facilitate the origination or formation of most of the organisms that are related to the different types of organisms. And we can say there was the formation of different kind of organism. Among them, the organisms that were most predominant were different types of reptile, birds, mammals, and different types of insects, along with some plants, some flowering plants. Which means we can say we can have some bryophytes, rhizophytes, and all these plants and animals began to appear in fossil record. We can have diversification of life form. So this Paleozoic era is actually the time period that was related to the formation of different types of organisms, and these all these events were actually having the kind of separation by different types of global mass extinctional processes, that these events are not continuous in their nature, but they are interrupted by different types of global mass extinction processes. These mass extinction processes might involve some type of catastrophic event, like different types of volcanic activities or global ice age. So we can have two types of categorizations. Number one, that is related to the diversification of organism, is there was the event that was too hot and that were too cold. The hot conditions were mostly related to the formation of different types of lava forms. The lava outflow was actually responsible for the extinction of different types of plants and animal species, and the different types of cold conditions that was also related to lava flow. The fumes, the smoke actually cover the total sunlight, and that facilitate the formation of other mode of life. The appearance and the dominance of flowering plants in the Cenozoic era that was created new habitats, niches for the insects as well as for the birds and mammals. It's mean there was gradual evolutionary processes were happening, and they were facilitating the formation of the habitat of different types of insects, birds, and mammals. And these changes in animal species diversity during the late Cretaceous and early Cenozoic were also promoting the dramatic shift. And the changes that were actually happening all these changes actually facilitate the animal species diversity. So we can say different types of animal and plant species were diversified during this time period. These are actually the type of regions that were related to the post-Cambrian life. Early in the Cenozoic, new ecosystem appears with the evolution of grasses and coral reefs. Late in the Cenozoic, further extinction followed by the speciation occurred during the ice ages that cover the high latitude with ice and then recreated, leaving the new open spaces for colonization. It means we can say there was the time period that was related to the formation of different types of organisms, and all those organisms were adapting to different types of mode of lives that were suitable for them. So we can say these events were not free of different types of extinctional processes. In this diagram, you can simply say we are actually discussing about Paleozoic era. This is actually the Dwyer eon. Paleozoic eon is actually the time that that is starting from 541 or 542 million years ago to up till present. That is actually the type of Dwyer. And in a lecture we actually have discussed there in the previous lecture we were discussing about the pre-Cambrian life. The pre-Cambrian was the kind of event that is having the different types of Dwyer, Neo-Proterozoic, Mesoproterozoic and Paleoproterozoic, and among them there was Hadrian and Archean was the type of Dwyer. As I have told you earlier in my previous lecture, that about 4,600 billion years ago, this was the process that was actually related to the Earth formation process. This was simply we can say the pre-Cambrian was the time when the Earth was formed. It means these Earth formational processes were the events that were involving oxygen accumulation, appearance of different types of prokaryotic and eukaryotic organism, bacteria, fungi, and then the Archean was the time period in which different types of oldest rocks were studied and earth crust was formed. And from that earth crust we can have Proterozoic. Proterozoic was the time when the life began in the sea. It means from sea, we will discuss about different types of life forms that gradually habituated towards terrestrial environment. In this Paleozoic era, we can have different types of Dwyer, that Cambrian. Cambrian was the time in which the different types of chordates and animals with different types of backbone, they began to appear in fossil record. Okay? Then these are actually the Dwyer of geological time scale that involved the Ordovician. Ordovician was the time that was having the major diversification of animal life. Then Silurian, that was this was the time when the first vascular plants were appeared in fossil record. Then Devonian was the time then when the first amphibians and fish was diversified. Then Carboniferous, first reptile, trees, seed and ferns. Then Permian, this was the time period that were then when reptiles were actually diversified. Then these are actually the Mesozoic and Cenozoic were actually the kind of Dwyer in which Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous and Tertiary, these all Dwyers actually involve the diversification of different types of organisms that involve in Triassic, first mammal and first dinosaur appear. In Jurassic, the first birds and dinosaurs diversity. And then Cretaceous actually involve the extinction of dinosaurs. First primates, first flowering plants, and then tertiary, the period and quaternary, then there was the process of human re-evolution and mammals were diversified. It's been, we can say, the the Cambrian life is actually the kind of Dwyer that is associated with diversification of life form, and the organism that began to appear during this post-Cambrian time period were the kind of organism that was serving as the base of these alpha layers. So we can say the pre-Cambrian and the from this pre-Cambrian we can have Dwyer, that is a Paleozoic Dwyer. This Paleozoic Dwyer involve the type of diversification of life forms. So we can see gradually there were different types of global mass extinctional processes in which were facilitating one kind of organism and other went extinct. It means all these organisms were diversified. They were originated in a way that all these organisms were serving as the baseline for the formation of different types of organisms, and this was the kind of event that was facilitating different types of organism evolution, and these evolutionary processes actually facilitate the formation of different types of organism. This is the post-Cambrian is the type of event that is related to the earth formational process. That is actually the kind of idea that is one school of thought. We actually not strictly rely on this idea. That is actually one kind of study or one school of thought. We can simply say that is actually related to different types of evolutionary processes that were facilitating the diversification.